shell. That's not the way to do it.
Egg.
Is not the way to do it because it's, you're going to eventually one of the shells will crack the egg yolk and then you're done. I mean, the best thing to do is like this. Look, you crack the egg, you put it into a bowl like that. Okay. Then, and then with your fingertips, you pick it up like this. You run it through your fingertips, and then you're left with a beautiful egg yolk that goes on this side. Can you do that? Go, show me how to do it. Ladies, very important, if you try this tiramisu, I mean, you know tiramisu, what it's like, it's got coffee and everything. I'm making it with cherries, which is really light, very summery. And that's it, run it through the finger, like that. Are you getting this? Yeah? Fantastic, bravo. Bravo, bravo. One more time. Oh! Ladies, be careful because we're using fresh eggs. So if you pregnantize, you can't have this one, yeah? Alright? Very, very important. Or whatever you guys say, up the mouth. If you up the mouth, you won't be able to have it. Alright? So very important. Any questions? Distracted for 20 seconds. I'm really sorry. Yes. Yes, madam.
Did you ever say between the
I can hear you. Can we get the microphone louder?
Did you ever think?
No, she's too loud now.
Did you ever think of taking up the profession as a comedian as opposed to a chef?
It's her 50th birthday today, and she was asking you if she could have a kiss from you.
Ooh!
I've got the messenger boy.
Who is she? 50? You're 50? Oh my God. No, come here, please. I want everybody to see. Watch and learn, ladies. How you should look at 50.
This is Kathy, everybody. Kathy.
You're 50? I don't believe you. Really? One second. No, I want you to turn around. 50. Incredible. Are you sure or you're 30 and just because you want a kiss? Are you sure? See, ladies, don't worry as you're getting older. Everything is going to be all right. diet, plus you can make a good soup with an old chicken, so it's fine. Very good. Egg yolk and sugar, you mix it together, and then it becomes pale. It's very important to do this now, because then the sugar is not going to be gritty in your teeth. Then I'm going to use a little bit of mascarpone cheese. That's going to go straight, minus the milk, into the egg yolk and the sugar. And what I want you to do is to press it down and mix it into the egg yolk. Okay, so it becomes all nice and creamy. I'm doing it.
Okay.
Well, it's easier, but by the time I've explained to you, I'll do it. What I did with the cherries, I'm using fresh cherries, and I pitted, I took the stone out, put them in a little saucepan, and a little bit of amaretto liqueur, and the job was done. Probably, what, 4 or 5 minutes we cooked them, and then you get these beautiful cherries. Cool them down, though, yeah? And then you can make these cherry tiramisu very easy. If you get any more questions, we nearly finished. So now is your chance to ask the question.
We've got a question over here. Here we go.
I'm going to put a touch of amaretto
liqueur.
Don't you
mix the egg white?
Sorry?
Don't you mix the egg white?
You don't need for this. Egg white is for the coffee one.
And you can use Savoiardi biscuit as well, yeah?
Sorry?
You can use Savoiardi biscuit as well.
Oh, yes. Yeah. I haven't finished yet. I was going to the Savoiardi. Everybody's a cook in here. Everybody's an expert all of a sudden. All right, cream is done. Beautiful. Okay? You want to make sure I put a little bit of amaretto liqueur in there. Would you like to try? You're not pregnant, are you? Very light. And what you want to do, just put a little drop of amaretto liqueur. You can put as little or as much as you like, but don't overdo it, because then when it goes into the fridge to kind of stay there and settle, the amaretto liqueur flavor will come out even more. Okay? So the cream is done, the cherries are done. Now we're going to use the Savoiardi biscuits. Okay, what do we do with the Savoiardi biscuits? In the cherry, when you cook them, I don't know if you can see, there is a little bit of liquid. Can you see it on the side there? Right? So, very simple. Savoiardi biscuits got the sugar on top and the sponge on the bottom. What I want you to do, you cut in half, get a biscuit, the sugar always stays on top, into the liqueur, like that, take it out, and then you start to make the first layer on the bottom. That's the only thing you have to do. Take it out, otherwise it's too moist. Too moist, yes. Take it out. No, that's not what I've done. Look, flat on the bottom. That's it. Excellent. Now, in there we're going to put a little bit of cream, just on top of the Savoiardi. Two tablespoons of cream, we'll do it. This is a great one to do for the summer, guys, yeah? Especially for the children, they don't want the coffee. Because probably they shouldn't have coffee. Do this one with the cherry, but don't put the liqueur. Oh, actually, put a little bit of liqueur so they go to sleep early. Then we do exactly the same thing. Savoiardi in half, goes in there, take them out, we do another layer. I'm going to do 3 layers. For a good tiramisu, remember, you need at least 2 layers of biscuits. But what I'm also, if I can get another spoon, please. Also, what I'm going to do, I'm going to get some of the cherries and I'm going to put in the middle layer, like that. Can you do that for me?
Yeah.
Then another biscuit, again, cut in half, into the liquid again, and then we're going to make 1 more layer. Then we're going to add it, the cream. Guys, any question before I go?
I'm over here, Tina.
What is your favorite Italian food? Hello?
Well, yeah, usually I need about 5 seconds of thinking time. Sorry. Therefore, where are you? Yeah. My favorite, I love anything to do with pasta. And one of my favorite Italian recipes is called Vitello Tonnato. It's the veal with the chili sauce. Very old fashioned Italian recipe. favorite. Beautiful, well done. No, I don't need another one. So then you get the cherries right at the end. You put it on top, like this. Can I do that? Guys, at this stage here, once you made the tiramisu, what I want you to do, you cover it with cream film, and you put it in the fridge for 2 or 3 hours. The cream sets, the flavor gets together. Your guest arrives, peel off the cream film. I've got a little bit of chopped hazelnuts, so you can use chopped almonds, whatever you guys fancy, chopped pistachio nuts, they will do. And you just put it on top. Can we show the one already prepared, Trish? There they are. Yes. Sorry?
Hi, Gina. Were the cherries already cooked or were they tinned? Sorry, I missed what you did.
Okay, you could use the tinned cherries. Absolutely fine. If you get a good quality one, they bring it. But what I did with the cherries, I got the cherries, take the stone out, put them in a little saucepan, amaretto liqueur, a little bit of sugar, a touch of water. You kind of cook them for about 3 or 4 minutes. Okay, just to create the liquor, and then cool them down, and that's what you've done. Nice and easy, but you can use the tinned cherries. But if they are in season, use fresh cherries. This is the one that they set in the fridge.
Can I ask you to use coffee?
Sorry?
The tiramisu, you must use coffee as well. Coffee?
Yes.
Very essential.
But not for this one, though. Sorry?
To the Savoyardi biscuit, she put some coffee.
Maybe you forgot that, he says.
When you make the traditional one with the coffee, that's when you make the coffee. I don't know if you remember, I said about 27 times, we are not making the one with the coffee, we are making a cherry tiramisu. It's just garlic.
What inspired you to be a cook?
Oh, that's finally a decent question. My grandfather used to be a chef, and he used to have a restaurant when I grew up in Naples. And when I was, how old are you? 7, 8?
7.
When I was about a year older than you, 8 or 9 years old, I used to go to his restaurant all the time. I used to peel in potato and wash pots and pans and wash the floor because I always find